Hey guys, today I will compare the book Miss Peregrine's Home for Peculiar Children and the movie adaptation by Tim Burton. Are there any similarities? Which one is better, the movie or the book? If you've seen the movie, do you also need to read the book? Without further ado, let's go.
Jake, right on time. Miss Peregrine, delighted to meet you.
He's invisible.
Of course. We're what's known in common parlance as peculiar.
Claire, why aren't you eating?
She's embarrassed in front of Jake.
Don't be.
First off, I've watched the movie first. The reason I wanted to see it wasn't that I heard the title or anything. It was because of this man. For those of you who aren't familiar with him, this is Tim Burton. He's an American artist, filmmaker, animator, and created some of my favorite movies of all time. For example, Corpse Bride, Charlie and the Chocolate Factory, both of them are from 2005, and Edward Scissorhands from the year 1990. And I'm the type of guy, when I get interested in an artist's work, I have to see and read everything. Same thing with Michael Jackson, Ed Sheeran, the 1975, John Green, and Stephen King. Some would say that Tim Burton's movies are creepy, scary, or bizarre. But for me, his movies always have some kind of wonder within them. The movie score is composed by Danny Elfman, plus the visual storytelling by Tim Burton, plus Johnny Depp is always a great combo. But Miss Peregrine's Home for Peculiar Children was only directed by Tim Burton. There was no Johnny or Danny. But like I said, if I get interested in an artist's work, I have to see and read everything. So I had to watch Miss Peregrine's Home for Peculiar Children. So to wrap up the story as quick and spoiler-free as possible, the movie as well as the book are about Jacob Portman, a 16-year-old boy. When Jacob was younger, his grandfather told him stories about peculiar children who live on an island. Jacob loved these stories and also thought that they were true, till he was old enough to question them. Jacob then one day received a distress call by his grandpa and rushed to him, only to find him dead lying in his yard, slain by a mysterious beast. He started rambling about a man's grave and a loop. Then Jacob starts having these nightmares of monsters. He remembers the children his grandpa told him about, and to overcome these nightmares, he tries to find answers on the island. So, are there any similarities? I mean, yeah? A very similar plot and almost the same characters. Why almost? Tim Burton, or someone else, changed Emma and Olive for the movie. Emma is still kind of Jacob's love interest, kind of weird because she was also in a relationship with his grandpa, but however she has Olive's peculiarity, and vice versa. But if you think about it, it kind of makes sense? After seeing the movie, I did a bit of research to see if there will be a sequel, because the book has one called Hollow City. But the only site I could find was Screen Rant. Screen Rant wrote, there was talk of a Miss Peregrine franchise that could become the next Harry Potter. But also that Miss Peregrine pulled in almost $300 million worldwide against $110 million production budget. But considering Hollywood's accounting dictates a film must have at least double its budget to make a profit, Miss Peregrine's box office performance wasn't all that impressive. Or at least not enough to impress Fox, who's since gone quiet on the matter of a sequel. Add to that the film's lukewarm reception among critics and it looks like the likelihood of a Hollow City movie is slim. Plus a thing that could speak against a sequel too would be the fact that Tim Burton has never made a sequel except for Batman. So maybe Olive and Emma were changed to make a sequel impossible? I don't know. However, after starting Hollow City the book, they would have to make a lot of changes and maybe that would be a disappointment for some of the fans. Let's say Hermione from Harry Potter would be a guy or Ron would be a girl. Some of the dynamic, dialogue and plotline had to be changed. If they'd done this, maybe Harry Potter wouldn't be as iconic as it is, because the book and the movies are so similar. Before we go into which one is better, you have to know that I never been the book guy. I hated reading in school and avoided every single book as good as possible. And now Miss Peregrine's Home for Peculiar Children was the first real book I finished, I guess? I also tried to read John Green's book, The Fault in Our Stars, but I wasn't as dedicated as I am now. I wanted to read the book, so I can't speak as a I read 100 books guy. I can only give you my honest opinion as a guy who's fairly new to books, as sad as it is. To be fair, I wouldn't have read the book if the movie wasn't good. I loved it. It was something new, at least for me. It wasn't about knights or magicians or that kind of stuff. The story is about, like it says, peculiar children. About Emmer, who can create and control fire. About Hugh, who has bees living inside of his body. About Brownwin, who has super strength. I know it kind of sounds like a spin-off of The Incredibles, but it is not. The most important thing for me is that the story feels real, that I care about the characters, their journey, their emotions, and I do here. I just realized we haven't talked about Ransom Riggs, the author of the book series. He has created this world, stories, and characters. I'm so happy he did. Do you know how he created it? You don't? Let me tell you. He always liked collecting weird, strange, but beautiful old photos on flea markets. He collaborated with other collectors and wrote a story to these photos. I know it sounds kind of weird, but he did it very, very well. Either these are photos Jacob finds or an object he sees. That's kind of cool. But which one is better, book or movie? I really have to say, as much as I love the movie for the visuals, I love the book even more. It covers some things I felt were missing in the movie. Jacob's relationship with his parents and how he decides to leave his family to travel with the children. It was all unanswered in the movie, and also the ending was kind of unsatisfying in a way. But that doesn't mean that it's a bad movie. I still love it, but I got answers to all my questions in the book. So I would say, if you plan on watching the movie after you've read the book, I think you won't be as satisfied as the other way around. If you like or love the movie like I do, and you want to get to know the characters even better, I would hardly recommend you to read the book. So if you liked the video, make sure to leave a like, subscribe, ring the bell, and stay safe, but even more important, stay peculiar.